Hey Frost, I'm asking for something stupid here. How did you do chorded verse?
Well, finger thing, that's both a simple and a tough question. First, I'll cover what you need for the section. You need either a 2-2 strum bar with good technique or a 4-2 strum bar, good luck finding one of those, and you need a lot of either patience or stupidity, whichever works best for you. When looking at a section like chorded verse, it's important to understand how to break down the section, because in all technicality, it's just a massive 256 note long blob. This section is split into 32 mini blobs of differing location but of all the same note structure. Despite this being an April Fool's chart, I'm at least glad the charting is consistent, otherwise I wouldn't have been able to milk that sweet, sweet ad revenue. To start off, let's just cover a single oscillation of the blob, just 8 notes. Keep in mind that these notes are very close together on full speed, 42 notes per second in fact, so some functions of clone here that I'm explaining here won't work with most other sections. Before looking at strumming at all, you can already kinda see how the section is possible if you've paid attention to Clone Hero gameplay at all. What we have is a hopo which can be ignored, a strum and a chord followed by a hopo which can also be ignored, then a chord, a hopo which can't be ignored, and two strums located after that hopo. The reason the first two hopos can be ignored is due to the game mechanic that allows hopos to automatically be hit when holding the higher notes in a sequence, hence why chords with hopos between them typically auto-hit the hopos. The second one can't be ignored because it's in a position that isn't at the highest point of an anchored sequence when playing the previous note, so it's something that has to be paid attention to. When I tackled this section, I started off by trying to double accent a descending triplet input, putting more emphasis on the top and the bottom of the wrist rotation to ensure that the notes at the beginning and the end of the sequence work properly, and allowing CH's strum leniency engine to account for everything in between. This is actually how I got my first 100% overstrum of the section, but it's so wildly inconsistent that it made grinding the section a massive chore. What I eventually figured out is that the beginning emphasis can be extended to cover the first 4 notes rather than the first 2, meaning the entire first half of the cycle can be consistent so long as each input starts off by holding the top 2 notes of the triplet rather than just the top 1. Then the end can be input the same way and all that's left is the second chord and the third hopo. By rotating your wrist off of the top 2 notes and moving towards the leftmost note, the strum leniency can be used to input the second chord, which is fantastic. Now, to cover strumming, what I did in specific was input 4 strums here and 2 here. But wait, why 4 there when there's only 2 strum notes? The first hopo in the sequence gets ignored because I fret slightly earlier than I strum, meaning for those 3 notes, there's 4 strum inputs. Typically, that means the hopo would double register the strum because Clone Hero sucks, but by fretting at just the right time to move downwards, the hopo only accepts 1, properly, and carries the next input over to whatever note is next in the sequence, in this case being the second chord. The third hopo is the biggest threat to my method, since inputting the up flick on the strum bar even a frame too early would make the hopo suck up an input, ending the run right there, which is where 99% of my attempts when first trying to FC the section died, but by inputting the up flick late enough, the hopo will be registered as a hopo properly, and the up flick will register the 2 strums at the end. So in this example of the first cycle, the full method is as follows. Press down orange and yellow at the same time, wait 1 note, perform a down rake motion which inputs 4 strums, such as middle index flick or index thumb flick. At around the same time the 4th strum registers from the strum bar, begin to pull off the orange to input the red. Then pull off yellow so you're only holding red, wait a single note, then perform an up flick that registers 2 strums, such as index flick or middle flick, and bang, that's 1 of 32 cycles complete. Now do that 32 times in a row at 42 notes per second, smile.
Yeah, I don't know either. Subscribe!